Hey friends, Andrew here, hope you're well. Installing new apps can supercharge your Mac or even breathe fresh air into older Macs. So let's take a look at 14 incredible new Mac apps that will help save you more time, become more productive, and secure your Mac. Best of all, the apps that I'll be sharing today in this video are completely free to use, so I'm certain that you'll install at least a few of these by the end of this video. Let's jump right into the first app. If you ever worry about your Mac being stolen, this first app, it's a must download. It's an app called Clyde and it lives in my toolbar up here. So it's this icon right there. And if I go ahead and toggle Clyde, what it will do is lock my Mac, as you can see. And this is where it gets really useful. So if I now close my MacBook or take it away, it will sound an alarm right there. So it's really loud and it'll sound that alarm and it'll also notify my phone. I cannot tell you how many times I've been in a cafe where I'll be in the flow with work, I'm working away, but I really need to go to the toilet, but I couldn't ask someone to watch over my laptop. So I ended up having to leave the cafe. So this app, Clyde, gives me the peace of mind that I'll be able to leave my Mac in a public space with that alarm on. So next up is Portal. And it's one of my favorite productivity booster apps. It's a really beautiful app that acts as a Mac Zen mode when I need to do deep focus work. So say when I need to focus, I'll click on focus right here. Then I'll choose one of the surroundings and then set that backdrop. Let's just go with this one here in Iceland and then click set surroundings. So as you can hear, it will immediately turn on spatial audio supported white sound, change the backdrop of my desktop to a beautiful 8K cinematic backdrop, and it can also be linked up to smart lights to change your physical surrounding. It's such a simple yet beautiful app, and it helps me get in the flow for challenging work. And best of all, it's completely free. It's also just a really beautiful app with a bunch of different backdrops and sounds. And I find it really useful when I need to focus. Another great productivity app I use is Hazeover. Now, Hazeover, if I bring up just a random window here, this app helps me focus on one task at a time by highlighting the front window. So for example, if I've got this window up here and I go ahead and open up Quick Notes on Notes, as you can see, when I pull up this window, it fades out all the background windows, and this is perfect for monotasking. In the settings here, there's a satisfying twist knob action where you can adjust the dimming with that twist on your trackpad. As you can see here, I typically like to set it at about 50 to 60%. There's also background colors that you can change here. You know, I don't know why you'd stick to anything else but that black. As you can see, red looks really intense, but I stick to black. I find it very clean and it just helps me focus on that single window. But yeah, I'm someone who has all sorts of apps and tabs open and it's an absolute cluster mess to navigate. And so we all know that heavy multitasking kills productivity. So Hazeover is just a really simple app that helps turn distractions down and then focus on my one current task. The next app is called Audente. It's a great free app that helps my Mac's long-term battery life. So what it does is if I click into it right here, as you can see, it's able to restrict my battery charging up to a certain percentage. So in this case, I've set it to 70%, and this just helps it avoid overcharging. And this is perfect if you have a MacBook docked like I do most of the time. And if I click into the settings here, you can see a bunch of advanced features in the pro version, like heat protection, battery calibration, and automatic discharging if you're really serious about keeping an eye on your Mac's battery health. But I'm currently just using the free version to limit battery charging when my MacBook is in clamshell mode docked to my monitor. It's a great set and forget type of app that will hopefully allow you to use your precious Mac that much longer. The next Mac app I love is called Itzycal. I'm not sure how to pronounce it, Itzycal or It's Ycal, whatever it is, it's a great calendar app to make use of the menu bar space. So once it's installed, you can see that I've got the date of the month right here, rather than checking my phone, Googling the date, or bringing up my Apple calendar. Plus, when I click into it, it's a fully functional calendar right here. And it's a really convenient and fast way to access my calendar. And then double clicking into a date, you can then see that it gives you the ability to schedule in events, and it's fully functional. And yeah, I use it to be able to quickly glance at the date or view and create calendar events no matter which app or window I have up. It's really useful having a calendar integrated into the menu bar. I'm surprised that Apple hasn't done it just yet. I wouldn't be surprised if they add that as a new feature in the future. But for now, this app is great to have in the menu bar. Now, if you have an external monitor with your Mac, the Monitor Control app right here is a great app to have. And I use it all the time with my LG ultrawide display. I've got it up here in the App Store to show you because I can't really demonstrate it right now with just my MacBook. But yeah, it's able to control non-Apple external monitors' brightness, contrast, and volume as if it was a native monitor. So as you can see, it's a pretty stock standard app. You're able to control multiple displays as well. Plus, it's able to sync up your brightness from your MacBook to the external monitor and dim all the way to full black. It's just a really useful app if I'm working late at night and need the brightness to be bumped up quickly. For example, I can just go ahead and tap that and control that directly from the Mac, and it will display natively on the external monitor. Next up is an app to replace the very underwhelming default preview app when managing PDF documents on my Mac. So PDF Gear right here is a free PDF editor for Macs. So it allows me to sign PDFs, edit text, compress PDFs, merge, and all that good stuff, as you can see right here. All the tools are here. It basically has everything that you need and you'd get from Adobe's Acrobat Reader, but instead it's completely free. Plus, I think they've recently added nifty AI powered tools. So I'll give an example here. If I just open up a random PDF here, so you can go ahead and compress the PDF itself. You can also crop in, you can convert the PDF into a Word document, Excel, whatever it might be. You can mark it up. You can also go ahead and even sign the document. And there is also integrated nifty AI powered tools. I believe it's integrated with ChatGPT 3.5. So if you click this little button here, and now you can go ahead and chat to the AI bot. So if I say like summarize, if I click summarize this PDF, you can see that it literally summarizes the entire PDF. So yeah, that's PDF Gear. It's an app that I get almost all the time for all my new Macs, since we all deal with PDF documents, and it's just a great free alternative to all the paid PDF apps. So the next app, it's not so pretty and fun as you can see here, but it is really useful and will save you a load of your time. It's called Transnomino, and it's able to rename a bunch of files all at once. So let's say, for example, here, I want to clean up all the file names in a certain folder. Well, all I'll do is I'll go click this and find what I want to fix up. So let's say I want numbering in front of the file names. I'll click this, then I'll go ahead and add the separator that I want, and then the offset, and then where I want the position to start. So this might be confusing, but I'll just show you how it works. So let's take this folder here and drop it in. So you can see immediately with the original file name here, I now have numbering automatically. And I personally like to have 3-4 digits. So you can go ahead and customize it here. Let's bring it up to 3. And you can see here, it is now more organized automatically. And all I'll do is click rename right there. It's renamed it automatically, just like that. I'll click in and you can see immediately that everything is renamed. I can now go ahead and sort by name, and everything is just nice and neat. And that's exactly how I like things. Otherwise, things are just all over the place. So this app is absolutely great. It's overpowered in my opinion. Now, one of the better photo editing apps is Photomator. It's a great alternative if you don't want to use Lightroom Or if you want a more affordable alternative to Lightroom, this is probably the one for you to check out. As you can see here, it looks exactly like Apple's default Photos app, and I think that's a point. It syncs up to Apple's photo app and InCloud albums. They will all appear here in PhotoMator, so this makes it really easy to access and edit personal photos. The main reason I use PhotoMator next to Lightroom is the PhotoMator's great auto enhance functions that use machine learning to get the photo right by just using one button. So I'll give you an example. Let's just jump into this one. This isn't edited. And there is this button right here, which I use all the time. If I just click on it, it automatically enhances the photo. And as you can see there, let me turn it off and on so you can see the difference here. I think it does a really good job for a one-click enhance functionality. So what I would do from there, I would click onto these sliders, and there is a lot of customization and control that you get. So there's filters down here that you can use, as you can see. And then I can go ahead and control exposure slightly, you know, turn down, up the highlights, everything that you normally get in Lightroom, it's all here. And overall, it sort of just reminds me of Apple Aperture back in the 2010s, if anyone remembers that app before it was removed by Apple. It's the one app on this list that isn't completely free. There is a free trial and a once-off lifetime fee of, I think it was about $150, which is great if you're not a fan of Adobe's ongoing subscription fee. This is a great alternative. The next app I absolutely love is Recut. And this app, it's a must-have for video editors and content creators. It's a really simple app where if you drop in a video asset, what it will do is it will then clip all the silent parts of your talking head video clip, and it will automatically remove all the silence and stutters right away. Now, the video that I pulled in here is already edited, but I just wanted to give you an example. So once it's pulled in here, what you will do then is just go ahead in the minimum duration, how long you want the silence to go on for before it's cut out. And then you can also leave space between the cuts. Typically, I like this to bring this down so it immediately jumps to the next clip. And then remove blips too. So what you can do from here is click export and then export into Final Cut Pro, for example, and then continue editing there. This app easily saves me 10 to 20 minutes manually cutting the video files myself since I started using the app years ago now. Really, really great in terms of like saving me a ton of time and not having to just cut out all the silence. The next one is a super simple one, but a very handy one, HEIC Converter. So if you have an iPhone, chances are that your photos taken are saved in this format, HEIC, unless you've manually changed them in settings. HEIC is a great file format for saving storage space, but not so great when it comes to using the photos because it's just not as compatible as good old JPEGs. So what I'll usually do is just airdrop the photo to my MacBook. As you can see, it's in HEIC format. I'll just drag this in. And as simple as that, you can then adjust the quality and also change it to PNG if that's what you want. Then go ahead and click convert. That's it, simple as that. And I actually use this converter quite often when sharing content and pulling in casual photos for the blog posts, for example. So I've mentioned this app plenty on this channel before, and I still love it. It's Xsnip. In my opinion, it's still the best free screenshot app, and it loads better than the default Command Shift 4 on Macs. So I've mapped the Xsnip shortcut to Command Shift 9. And then as you can see, I've got the tool up now. And what you can do is quite a lot, actually. You can snap onto certain windows. You can go ahead and, you know, just take a screenshot of something in particular, and you can go ahead and, you know, draw around it. You can adjust the colors. You can add in arrows here, like so. You can go ahead and number things if you need to, even add text in there. You can just do a lot, and then you have the option to either save it or you can copy and paste it to your clipboard just by pressing spacebar. Now I've got it on my clipboard. This app is so useful. I use it literally daily. It is just so much better than the default screenshot app. Handbrake is a tool that is a must-have if you deal with any type of video formats. It's not very fancy and has a wacky, unrelated app icon, as you can see here, a cocktail and a pineapple that I've never understood. If anyone understands why that app icon is, let me know down in the comments. But what it does is it's able to batch convert videos from practically any format to most supported codecs. So if I pull in those video formats here, you can see now that once it pulls in, I can adjust the dimensions, I can adjust the resolution, I can adjust filters, video, frame rate, audio even. So why this is so useful is this app actually saved my ass when my camera recorded all my footage in a broken format thanks to a Sony firmware update. But I was able to convert all 100 plus video files back to H.264 compression in one go. So it's a great app to have downloaded and stored ready to use if you ever need to batch convert a bunch of video files. Okay, and then finally we have Hand Mirror. This is an app that lives on your menu bar again, as you can see right here. And if I click onto it, so this is an app that lives on your menu bar and works like a mirror to check your webcam and frame yourself before your video call. If you're on Mac OS Sonoma, you can also test the new effects here too. And this is just really, really useful. It's infinitely easier way to check everything looks good and is in frame before I jump on a Zoom call or a Google Meet, rather than having to fiddle around with Zoom settings to check or even jump into Mac's photo booth. Hand Mirror is right there. It's quick and easy check. A great one if you take a lot of video calls. So which of the 14 Mac apps did you end up downloading and which one is your favorite? Let me know. If there's any apps that you feel should be on this list, please feel free to comment them down below and share them with me. I love trying new apps. If you made it to the very end of this video, also comment the code word productivity. I'll drop a video right here to another 12 Mac apps that I love for you to check out. And as always, thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next video.